Welcome, welcome, welcome. I am the FX Savant, and in this video, I have an NZD USD short for a 4.1 risk to reward, risking about 16 pips to gain an overall 67 pip TP. And also, I want to speak about waiting for your setups in this video. If that interests you, do me a favor, drop me a thumbs up, make sure you're subscribed and those post notifications are on, and let's get into the video. Let's hop on the chart. We are on NZD USD on the daily time frame. I don't think it's necessary for me to do a full time frame analysis starting from the monthly on this one. Pretty much got the premise of how I do my trading and how I analyze the charts. So on the daily, what can we see? Well, we're currently in an impulse phase. So the market has just made a move to the upside, breaking structures. We broke this level of structure, the most recent level of structure, and then we broke this level of structure, which is a major level of structure, which is the high. So we broke and closed above both levels of structure on the daily. Well, we did not get to participate in the impulse move to the upside. So what can we do? We can wait for a retracement, a correction, and exhaustion. All right, so we can counter trend trade this by getting in on the exhaustion, on the correction, on the retracement, whatever you want to call it. Where would the market most likely stop since we are breaking structure to the upside in an impulse correction, an impulse move to the upside? Yes, we would ideally like to be buying this market, but we can take advantage of the corrections and short this market. Where would the market most likely go to before the market continues to the upside? Well, the market used most previous resistance now turn support is what should act in the market that would continue to the upside. So the most recent resistance is right in here. Yes, this is the major resistance level that we broke above, but as you can see, level was created back here. Then we continued to create a resistance level in here, and then we had broken it most recently. So the most recent level of resistance now turn support would be right in here, which is also a what pattern? You know, I talk about it all the time, a bing bing that we would like to see complete at the neckline. So we have an W formation that we would like to see complete overall at the neckline. That is our premise behind this trade, and we're on the daily. So this is the day before I come to the market and I set up my trades the day before. I saw this looked like a candle that indicated that this market would like to start the retracement. So we have a black candle, which for me is my red candle, my bearish candle. And as you can see on the 4 hour, what happened? Well, we were stepping up, making moves to the upside, breaking structure to the upside until the end of the day. At the end of the day, we ended up closing below structure, breaking and closing below structure, which is an indication or a setup or market structure that we would like to sell. So this is ideal. If we just created an impulse to the upside, we cannot move in one direction forever. We need to correct or exhaust or retrace the market moves in waves. In order to move higher, we need to come down a little bit, collect some orders, collect some more momentum, collect some buying power, and vice versa if we are selling. If we're selling, we're moving down, we need to come back up a little bit in order to continue going down. So since we started to break structure, that's indicating that yes, the bears are coming into this market, not necessarily taking over the market and want to see impulses to the downside, but for the time being, and our higher time frame says that this is the most recent resistance now turn support. Let's see if it will get a tested. And we want to take advantage of this move, not by jumping into the move and predicting the move. We want to react to what's going on. So this is waiting for our setups. Now that we see that the market has broken structure to the downside, we don't just blindly get into a trade, into a short trade, and target the downside, put our stops above the high. We want to react to what the market's doing. We're not trying to predict the market. Yes, the market broke structure, but that doesn't mean it has to stay below structure. So if we see on the 4 hour, this is the end of the day. I'm going to sleep. Let's wake up. Let's go. When I wake up, this is end of the 1 o'clock candle. So let's go. Ooh, I went way too far, huh? 1 o'clock right here. So at 1 o'clock, I'm waking up. I see this is our level that we identified as most recent support now broken. Want to see it tested and acting as resistance. So we don't just blindly trade from here because what? We're breaking structure to the upside. Yes, we had an inverted head and shoulders, which is also telling us that the market is not ready to come to the downside because what? We had a level, we broke below it, immediately closed back in the level, retested the left shoulder, and continue to go higher. Go watch that video if you don't know about head and shoulders. It's pretty good. But we broke back into the structure. We retested the left shoulder and we did not break below. This is not when we want to sell this market. This is not when I want to sell this market, when I want to get involved. This is when I'm awake, when I'm at the market. Yes, probably could have entered into the market right around here, but I wasn't awake. So I'm not entering on this 1 o'clock candle because we're breaking structure to the upside. I want to sell this market. I'm waiting for my sell setup. I'm waiting for my bias to show itself and give me an opportunity opportunity to trade this market. This is not ideal. If we play it forward, what do we see? Yes, we've retested the high of this structure, of this level of structure right here, and we continue to move down, or we reject it from this area. We failed to break this level of structure, our shoulder area. Not until we break that area do we want to sell this market. So that's all I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for structure to break to the downside, creating lower lows and lower highs for me to enter in on this market. The market closed below it, but it didn't close below the lowest support level. So yes, we retested it. We have the candle that the next one's supposed to fill in the wick, but the wick did not close below the lowest low of the structure. So we're not breaking structure really until we break below this low. You can get a break below this low and come retest in this area, and that would indicate that we are in a sale structure, sale market structure, or a bearish market structure. But we did not break below that low. Yes, we were looking for a close below this area. We got it, but it wasn't really exact. I'm willing to wait on this market to give me my ideal setup. And remind you, this is not here yet. We just have this level as where we want to see the market go to. So I'm playing it forward one more time, and I see this candle happens, and I'm like, okay, what can I take from this? This is a little market manipulation. So we wanted to take out stops of everyone who shorted underneath this level, take out their stops. They put them right up. They put their stops right up in here, right above the highs, and they wanted to take them out. So I'm waiting on this. I know that until we break above this level, this high, I mean, technically this high up here, but it would be this level right in here that we would need to break above in order to be back into the bearish market, because we had an impulse to the downside. So we're still within this impulse. This is our impulse to the downside. Until we break out of this impulse to the downside, we're still in a sell bias market. Now for me, this was the ideal area you would want to short from, or I would want to short from, or the typical trader would want to short from. This is the ideal area. The most recent support now acting as resistance, but we broke back above it. A little market manipulation from just being in the market for a while and seeing some things. I know that that is just price wanting to grab some more orders. And I see that. Actually, let me go back one candle. On the 15 minute, what can I see? I see that this is our level that we don't want to see the market break above in order to continue selling. But do I want to hop into this market immediately? Just because I know, hey, this level is what's supposed to hold and we should see the market move into a bearish market structure? No. I say, hey, I can see that this, which after this area we identified, this most recent support level, after we identified this level, I can see that once this was broken, that this wasn't the true level. This was not the true level that the market was respecting. Yes, we have little consolidation around this area, but this was not the level the market was respecting because it wasn't the most recent. The most recent support was right around in here. We wanted to see it act as resistance. It did act as resistance once here with a huge rejection, a wick rejection to the downside. So that's further indication that this is the area that the big players are playing at. And you can see that NZD USD at 5:30, around 5:30 in the morning, 5 o'clock, I saw this. This is what I saw, that this level was supposed to act as the most recent support, now acting as resistance. So once I saw that this candle, this black candle, this bearish candle had a little rejection into it, I was like, well, this is the area I want to participate in. I want to see the market participate in this area because we have broken structure. We're coming back to retest it on a higher time frame. This is a break of structure and a retest. This most recent support now broken and retested as resistance. So we entered in 5:30, thought this candle was going to be a little retracement candle. So we entered in on the next candle. Price put us in a little bit of drawdown, but like I said, this was the level of resistance that was supposed to hold this market all the way to our TP. We had market playing around with this for a minute. You see that we come and retest this area by the pip. And then once we get that area, we get the rejection into profit a little bit, come retest our entry, playing around this area, most recent support now acting as resistance. Now they're starting to act as strong resistance. As you can see, the market's not breaking above it. I'm saying, okay, the market is holding at our entry. We got a pretty good entry. Let's hold it. We're not risk-free yet because the market still has an opportunity to retest our entry. Don't want to just close, be stopped out on this trade at entry only to see the market hit TP. We have two levels of structure right now acting as resistance in order for the market to hit our stop loss or to hit my stop loss. So not really worried too much. Market is starting to break to the downside. And then we finally get our break to the downside and the market moves pretty easily, pretty strong, pretty smooth to the downside, breaking structure, putting us further in profit, and we're risk-free. So we're risk-free around this time. Market doesn't matter what happens. We just let the trade play out, and letting the trade play out, we see that we got our TP reached pretty nicely. The market came down, spiked into our TP and played around a little bit, and then continued to move to the downside. So we waited for our setup, waited for the setup to occur. I wanted to short this market, but I didn't didn't just short this market blindly immediately just because I wanted to be in a trade right now, or I didn't want to miss out on this trade right now. I identified some things in the market on each time frame. So on the daily, I identified something. On the 4 hour, hour, and 15 minute, I also identified something consistent to the way that I analyzed the market. So it's nothing new. I didn't do anything different that I've done in the previous videos. I've done the same thing on all time frames. I'm looking for specific things that percentage wise work out for me. They're my strategy that I can trade profitably and I'm consistently following my rules to the T. So as you can see, this trade was hit pretty easily after TP. We just waited for my setup. So I didn't enter in on the market until I got exactly what I wanted. And then I put my stop loss above the structure, targeted the lows and had a favorable risk to reward. And I overall took the trade. I wasn't afraid to take the trade. I know that over the long haul, the probabilities are in my favor. Yeah, just a little quick breakdown. Not too long. Wanted to go over this NZD USD trade. Just let you know, man, wait for your setup. Be patient. Wait for exactly what you want to see. Don't take any trades unless you see that, because that is your edge. That's the reason you can win in this market. That's the reason why you can win in this, is that you wait for exactly what you tested. If you don't, you're probably going to lose the trade because you haven't tested it. You don't know how the market will react or what to do in the situations that you haven't tested. So make sure you test your strategy, back test, follow your trading plan to the T. Don't break any rules. Do what you're supposed to do, and you know exactly what you're supposed to do. That's the thing. You know what you're supposed to do, but sometimes you don't do it. I want you to do exactly what you're supposed to do. Stick it out and wait for your setups, man. If you're looking for sales, the market looks like it's close to where your TP would be. Don't sell immediately. Wait for your ideal setup. If you're waiting for a pullback, wait for the pullback. You may have a big retracement and give you an opportunity to get in at a better price than what you originally wanted to get in, with a better risk to reward, and go around and hit your TP. So wait for your setups, man. Other than that, I hope you are having a profitable day on and off the charts. And until next time. I holla. Make sure you thumbs up, like, and subscribe too, though.